Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of You Should Play. Today we're looking at Valheim. Now, Valheim is a brutal exploration and survival game for 1 to 10 players. It's set in a procedurally generated purgatory inspired by Viking culture. Battle, build, and conquer your way to a saga worthy of Odin's patronage. The developer is Iron Gate AB, and the publisher is Coffee Stain Publishing. Valheim is an early access game, and it is right now priced at $19.99. So, this game is really wild. It's already had over a million players in its first week on Steam. And with every You Should Play, the first thing that we do is check out the settings menus. We've got everything from full rebindable keys, which is really nice to see. There is partial controller support, but the prompts do not show up as controller prompts. They show up as keyboard and mouse prompts. So if you have a Steam controller, you can definitely be used to something like that. But I don't see full controller support happening just yet. We've got typical audio effects, nothing major. Graphical fidelity, we're at 1440p at 144 FPS. But I'm normally getting around 59 to 60 FPS in this game. It is unoptimized because it is early access, but there are things like bloom, SSAO, probably reduced sun shafts, get a better frame rate, things like that. So we're going to go into miscellaneous or some language options too, tutorials, stuff like that. So what I did was I actually played this game for about an hour and a half or so. I didn't want to do everything in the beginning. I wanted to get my feet wet in this game because I don't really play many or any at all survival type games. I don't really play Rust, things like that. So this is really my first jump into this kind of game, and it's been definitely interesting, I will say that. So one cool thing is that this does have a lot of like PS1 sort of visuals to it, which I kind of dig. I love that old school style kind of look. And you do create your own world. You then have a seed for that world, and you can have it with multiplayer, or you can play solo too. So there are those options. You don't have to play multiplayer if you don't want to. So we're going to go ahead and log right in. I think one of the cool things about this game is that it's really set up in this cool kind of way where I like playing it when I'm done with like my regular day. If I just kind of like want to chill, sort of relax kind of a deal. And it puts me in this like really mellow kind of state, I guess, for the fact because I'm not doing any multiplayer or PvP. But it's such a wild kind of game that I'm not normally used to. And it's just interesting just to kind of experience. And Chungus has arrived. So welcome to Valheim. And this is all procedurally generated. I made my own little hut and house right here. My building is not that great because I am still learning quite a bit about how a lot of the game mechanics operate. There isn't really a lot in terms of guidance. The tutorials are very slim, and it's mostly about just sort of like expanding and exploring on your own. So a couple of things to note real quick. You're gonna see things very similar to, let's say, Minecraft and also other survival games. So if you haven't played those, you're in for a real treat because you're gonna really start to experience why people love those games so dearly. So you're gonna see quite a few tools that you need to craft here, food that you have to sustain. You have to make sure that you're rested. You have to make sure that you do all the specific things in order to survive. So the options that you have are pretty wild. So I've got a stone axe that I made because when you first start, you're naked and all you can do is punch. And the idea is you have to kill one of these gods that are part of each stone to get out of purgatory for Odin's blessing. And the only way to do that is to prepare yourself by surviving, crafting, building, and moving along the world and growing through that whole experience. Now you see those white lines that are passing over me, like usually up over the hut. That's the actual direction of where the wind is facing, because in this game, there's also sailing. You can sail to other locations and lands that have other resources and sail back to where you are. One of the first things you're going to encounter is that when you first start, you're going to have to build a workbench. Now, workbenches are pretty easy to build, and that's going to really help you across what you need to do. But let's get this land flattened down here, huh? Look at that. We're just going to pop that up real quick. Nice and level. We got to work on some other things here because, man, we don't want our house to be... We're going to build a new house. This house wasn't that great. So what we're going to do is just walk you guys through some of the beginning, since I know some of the stuff here is a little bit different than what a lot of people are actually used to. So one thing I noticed was the house I built over there is not on level ground. So I want to use my hoe and level off what I have here. If you're noticing why I'm not doing it all the time, it's because I have a stamina meter. And that stamina meter is what's going to be necessary for your survival. As you move on through the game, you'll notice that there are a quite a large compendium of things that you need. So you'll learn about like cold, death, food, altars, your hammer, your hoe, your inventory, things like that. As you play through the game, they'll come up, and there are guides for you as well. Here are my skills. You learn everything. The more you do it, the more you level it up. So it's got like some deep RPG mechanics as well, similar to like Morrowind or older RPGs that you might have played. So unarmed, jump, clubs, blocking, running, sneaking, axes, wood cutting, bows, stone cutting, mining, all that other good stuff. You've got some trophies as well. Now these trophies are what you use in order to call forth many of those gods to come forward and actually go ahead and summon them to fight them in order to defeat them. And then finally you can enable PvP if you want, but I normally don't. I keep this as more of like a single player, let me just sort of mellow out, build some stuff, do a couple of things, come back in a couple of days kind of way. So let's go ahead. We're getting kind of hungry. Oh, I just leveled up my running. Let's put on some boar meat on this here. Oh, we got to build a fire first. So let me make a fire. To do that, we'll just put that under there. I'm missing stone. Okay, so now we got to get some stone. Perfect. So let's find that. So I did hoe this ground a little bit. Here's some wood. We'll pick that up. And what we want to do is find some stone that we can use in order to build that campfire. So let's see, I'm running out of stamina. Now, as you run through the world, you can see the top right minimap that begins to open up the area that you're in. You definitely want to explore as much as you can because there are items and things that will definitely be beneficial for you to use and gain in the future. So that little sound was a deer. So you want to sneak up on deer, use a bow or sneak up on them and attack them if you can and try to grab whatever sort of meat or leather or hide that you can grab. So let's see if maybe this... Nope. Okay. So anything that lights up with a name, you can grab. There's a piece of dandelion. There's a branch. We'll get some wood. So you don't have to punch trees in the beginning. You can just pick up those items. And we got some stones here. Perfect. I think we can build a campfire because we are getting a little bit hungry. My food is starting to wear off. Now that's at the bottom left icon on the screen. When the food goes into the gray, you want to eat. And every piece of food has different stats and abilities that go to it. Oh, what is this? Check this out. I never saw this before. This is like a little mini house area. Like it's like broken down. Huh. Okay, that's kind of neat. So you know what? Let's do this. Let's go ahead and... Missing required craft... Okay, I forgot to tell you guys. So your crafting station has to be near you in order for you to use your hammer. And every crafting station has a radius that you actually have as part of the game. So you can't just build a crafting station and then just run off into the wilderness and think that's going to work. You kind of want to expand where you are and then move out from there. So I'll show you what that looks like when we get back to our hut. Alright, and as you can see, like, the land here is not very tilled. So let's just see if we can fix that here, huh? There we go. We can't get rid of that rock just yet. There we go. Looks a little better, right? Although we got like a little floating section here. We'll get to that in a minute. All right, let's go ahead and build us a little campfire. Perfect. We'll go ahead and cook some meat that I've got. We're going to wait for that sizzle. If we cook it too long, it'll turn to charcoal. We can make charcoal if we need to, but we'll get that with a kin later on. If you need charcoal early on, just burn your food. You can use that then. We're just waiting for that sizzle. And once we get there, we can go ahead and... There it is. It even changes the way it looks. Now you can go ahead and actually get burned by that fire, and I'd rather not. Now this meat, it's one weight, 40 health is what I gain back. I gain additional 30 stamina. It's for 1200 seconds and I get 2 HP per tick. So every tick of that time, I get HP back, which is really nice because I am down to 27 health, but at least now I am completely full and I'm good to go. All right, let's check out our workbench. Actually, yeah, we need to get some wood. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna act like we're here from the beginning and we're going to build a workbench. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna craft this workbench. We're gonna put that bad boy right about here. So you see how it turned red at one point? That means the ground is not level and you have to level that ground off before you can place it there. There we go. And now it's, I can put it there, right? So now it's level, it's good to go. And this is a good way to test if your ground is actually able to, you know, put your house on there and stuff like that. So let's put that bench. And a bench needs a roof. Yeah, you can't just go off ahead and start just crafting. See, crafting station needs a roof. Now that doesn't mean to build a house over your crafting bench. You can build sort of like a small little locate little thing for yourself, right? So we're gonna go to the building. And we're gonna build a wall here, right? Nothing too fancy, nothing too crazy. It doesn't have to be perfect, right? We're using the mouse wheel to actually turn it. Okay, and we'll go ahead and... Now there's a snapping mechanic that goes in with the sort of building here, which is kind of nice. And it all just kind of snaps into place. Now let's say if I need to break something down, it's the middle mouse button. And I can just do that there. And then all I gotta do is go here. Pop, and it snaps. Pretty easy, right? Not too bad. So right-click again, and we're gonna get ourselves a little bit of a roof. Doesn't have to be perfect. You can just sort of like place things where you need to. Let's just pick something better, right? Yeah, there we go. And look at that. We built ourselves like a little hut there, huh? Not too shabby. If you want to make it a little fancier, you can. Nothing wrong with that. We can go ahead and just sort of like put this... Let's turn that around. It's a little finicky here and there, but it's, you know, it's still early access, so I wouldn't toss it out in the trash just yet. There we go. And there we go. Look at that. We got ourselves a little crafting bench. It's got a little roof on it. We're good to go. Station is still too exposed. Okay. Let's go ahead and see what we can do here. Let's build another wall. And then we'll go ahead and put it to this side. Maybe this will work now. Yep. So I just need a little bit more on the side of the walls on the side. Doesn't mean I have to have a whole roof, but I had to have something. So here what we have is you have the repair tool. You can then repair your items if you need to. You can even upgrade them. So if I have to repair anything, it just repairs for free. There's no item equipment that I have to use in order to repair. It all comes just straight up. I can just fix it right then and there. I can then upgrade what I have if I have the right materials. So I need fire leather scraps and leather 2 of the station. So how do I get level 2 of the station? Well, I gotta build more things from the station. And how do you do that? Well, we just gotta find out what we gotta do. So if we build a rag tunic, rag pants, we can then level up the station and keep moving on. Remember when I showed you guys those skills in the beginning? Let's see if I can pull it up here. Boom. Those are the things you want to use when you build. The more you craft, the higher your actual skills go in terms of your workbenching. So let's see. Let's see if we can do a crude bow next. We need leather scraps. We have 10 wood. We need leather scraps to build it. We'll get that crude bow. And then we can upgrade these other things later, right? So let's go ahead and do that. So to get leather, I gotta go kill some boars. Uh-huh. See where this is going, y'all? You can tell where this is all going. Let's go see if we can find some stuff to kill. Let's see if we can actually get some stuff done. Now, the thing is, I wouldn't immediately run off to try and do those things all at once. But also, stealth reduces your stamina as you move. So if you start to lose stealth, you'll pop out. You won't be able to keep moving. And you'll actually be caught. So let's see if we can get some leather from boar. I think the boars were actually over in this direction. So I'm probably a little bit too far. Some more stone that we could use. That's not too bad, right? So yeah, this game had, oh, okay, there was a deer. I scared him. So what's cool about this is just it's so chill that I just really, really enjoy it. That's really like the big thing for me, is that everything is just sort of like this mellow, let's just sort of like hang out, do a couple of things. It's not this like intense pressure, because at night, when night does happen, there are enemies in this game, and the combat is similar to like a Souls game, to where you can like block, you can roll, you can do all kinds of stuff. So here's an enemy right here, actually, perfect timing. Or animations are, you know, part of it, and then they drop items. Pop, he's got resin. Yeah, I've already got that. Okay. So I did die over here for some point. Okay. Get some dandelion. I don't know what it's used for yet, but we'll find out at some time. Okay, so here's one of the stones that help you figure out what to do. There's also going to be other animals that come out and some spirits that actually assist you with that. So, this land is hard and wild, but we who are brought here are harder still. Take comfort, traveler, in the gifts before you, the good wood and stone, the fruits and flowers of the forest. Look also to the wild boar who roam these lands. They fear fire and the hand of man, but they can be taught to obey it. Go quietly to them, let them eat of your stock. Roots of the ground are their pleasure. So you can actually start building a farm too and start constructing it, and then having boar be in your pen, having them mate so you have a source of food to use constantly. It's just this huge cycle of like survival on your own, and it really makes this game honestly really interesting. This boar is probably going to mess me up if I don't sneak up properly. Okay, so now I'm increasing my sneak, which is nice to see. And then we're just going to go try to get a hold of this guy real quick. So I set up to loop the music, and I did think that's going to be a cool thing. There we go. Got him. Any leather? We only got raw meat. All right, so we got to keep looking for more boar to get more leather. Oh, we're going darker into the forest. Ooh, spooky time. Spooky time. What's over here? Another branch? Let's grab that. Look, another hut. No way. All right, we got a mushroom. Look at this. Oh, what's in here? Nice. Okay. Flint arrow. Coins. Huh. All right. You can cut down trees, but depending on your axe and what level you are, you may not even be able to cut them down because the wood's too hard. Huh. Good one. Oh, look, another boar. Okay. Two boars. Okay. Three. Okay. We're going to get some leather here, boys. Let's see if we can do that. Four boars. Yeah, good stuff. And now we're by the ocean, which is pretty neat. That boy hit me hard. All right, we got some leather scraps there. What you definitely want to do is, before you fight, you definitely want to eat. So that way you can get your health back during all that stuff. And you're not out in the wilderness, not eating, not having anything. And you're able to sort of like recover. I'm not dodging or blocking because I don't have a shield yet. Actually, I should probably build a shield to help out. More sneaking, level 9. So yeah, what's cool is you can just create this sort of like, you know, you can level up little things every single day, and you're not like, do it at your own pace. You're not like trying to rush through it to get to specific things. And it's kind of nice to just explore and see the world on how it's sort of like set up and what they've created. And here's Yggdrasil, the tree, which is kind of neat. Okay, you can hear me there. So what I'm going to do is I'm probably going to restart it when I'm done with the video. I've just been wanting to mess around and see what's there. I'm not really taking it too seriously. This boar has a star. It's probably a special. More raw meat, more leather. I feel cold because it's nighttime, y'all. Let's check out this water, huh? Not bad, eh? What happens when I go in it? Oh, I'm wet for 2 minutes? Okay. Oh, that uses stamina too. Jeez. Okay. Alright, let's take a look at what this stone says. This land... Okay, same thing. Same with boars. So I don't want... So what I want to do is... See if that works. Will he eat that? Come on, eat it. Eat the mushroom. I'm probably spooked him, which is probably why he's not. Oh, we're playing pillar hump. Come on, get the mushroom. Guess not. All right. There we go. Okay. And what I don't want to do is just die right off the bat in this. Because I usually, every time I do a You Should Play, I always die. Here's the thing, though. I'm wet, it's cold, it's nighttime, and I can probably freeze from hypothermia. So we have to get back to the camp as soon as possible. I'm also getting hungry, so we're going to eat that. And let's see if we can climb up here. Let me do this. Let me open up a torch. Get away from me! Okay, so let's go. Let's use this one. I like how he switches his hands when he's doing that, which is kind of neat. And let's see if we can actually just build. Because I think I have a fireplace in my hut. And we can just build the bow and see if we level up that workstation. Or our crafting at all. So the nice thing is it shows your bed on the mini-map, so you're never, like, lost about where to go, which is a cool thing. But let's take a look here. So what you want to do is you want to sleep at night. You don't really want to be out. And we're seeing some frame rate dips into the 30s and stuff like that. Since everything is procedural, that's sort of like the, And I'm on fire. Perfect. That's really what I wanted to avoid. Like I said, I don't have the right space for this. Let's build a crude bow. We have not leveled up to level 2 yet, but we have a crude bow. We can build some wood arrows. Build 20 of them. Okay. Let's move this here. I feel rested, there's comfort. That's nice. I'm glad. Let's see if what else we can build. A wood tower shell. I need 6 leather for that. I don't have enough leather. But we're just going to take a nap in the meantime. And that's what I've been noticing is the loop for Valheim. It's just this really wild kind of game where you can just sort of like do little things. Sort of like you can play it every day in game and see what you can complete there. You can just continue to push through and move from there. You can sort of like just... enjoy the world and sort of like relax after a crazy day at work or something. But I'm digging the fact that it's single player but also multiplayer, so your friends can get together. People have built like giant mead halls with this game. They've done a lot of wild stuff, so it's just kind of cool to see all these things coming together like that, and I'm honestly really digging it. Okay, let's see if we can actually cook some more meat, actually, because we're actually getting low on food. But this is such a wild thing. Like, I did not expect to sort of like love a game like this. I usually don't like games like this because I feel like the learning curve is far too steep. Although this does have a steep learning curve, there is enough information for you to gather in order to sort of like get a base understanding to complete the game. It just does take time, and you get to like plan things out and put things in like a cool way. So I'm digging it, especially like the sunrise kind of stuff. So let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Do you guys want to pick this up? I know a lot of people have actually been raving about it. I'm honestly enjoying it. It does need some work. It is still early access, so like I've said before, usually early access games I like to wait before they're at 1.0. but I, with the amount of people talking about this game so much so early on, I felt like, no, like I have to try this out and see what's happening. So if you guys like the content, go ahead and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys have a great one. You can check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It's at Oh No It's Alex. Or if you'd like to just stay on YouTube, you can. I always put more content here as well. You could also become a member if you want to support the channel directly. Thanks so much to everybody watching. I appreciate it. Have a great one, like I said before. And I'll see you guys next time. Let's kill this guy. You're going to get it, boy. You're going to get it. Bah! Oh, snap.